about that? Just to that feeling.
I've never seen stuff like this before, all this equipment.
Have you done any filming before?
No. First time.
How do you feel about it?
A little nervous.
Очень не по себе.
It's gonna do a little bit of powder here for you.
That's fine.
Ага. Теперь мне еще больше не по себе.
It's like 12, take one, Mark.
So no one really mentioned what this video is all about.
Dat is wel spannend, hè? Ik weet niet wat ik moet doen of zo. De aflezen of wat? Of moet ik afwachten?
Ja. Eu acredito que seja alguma coisa relacionada à parte de segurança, né?
Men zocht een vrijwilliger en ik heb ja gezegd, ja.
We're going to put some text up on the screen for you. And I'm going to ask you to just read through it.
Хорошо. Pelo menos para mim até tá...
Сколько у меня попыток?
Одна.
Одна?
Давай, сейчас попробуем.
Wat nu volgt is waar gebeurd. Alleen de namen zijn veranderd.
Max и uma vida boa.
Прекрасная семья, верные друзья и любимая работа.
Every day he had breakfast with his wife and three children.
Maria, de 2 anos, e 2 meninos.
Jacob van 4 en Ben van 7 jaar.
One day, the sunny autumn morning, Max was later than usual.
Пропустил завтрак, быстро попрощался с семьей и побежал к автобусу, как раз вовремя успев на него.
Ele trabalhava na ArcelorMittal há 12 anos e os últimos 5 tinha sido na área de laminação.
Max was known as the kind of guy who made everyone feel good just by being around.
He was behulpsam and vrolijk.
Он был благосклонным и веселым. У него всегда хватало энергии, чтобы выполнить работу на отлично, чего бы это ни стоило.
Aquele turno, como todos os turnos na laminação, começou com uma conversa sobre segurança. Conduzido pelo supervisor da área.
Max was kraandrijver in de verzending.
There was a lot of work to do that day, but he had a magnetic lifting system on the spread bar to help him.
Max она очень нравилась. Работа с ней шла значительно быстрее, чем со стропами или цепями.
One of his first jobs that day was moving the bundles of long product by the bending machine.
Ele posicionou a ponte rolante e preparou para baixar o eletroímã.
Maar het was druk in de ruimte en Max wilde er zeker van zijn dat hij de juiste stapel te pakken had.
So he went over to check the label.
Hij acabou colocando o controle remoto sob seu ombro.
Чтобы ему было легче приседать, рассматривая маркировку.
Toen hij erover boog, had hij geen idee welke fout hij had begaan.
His elbow caught the remote control.
Mas Max não percebeu o que tinha feito.
Он также не заметил, что электромагнит начал двигаться к нему.
Макс had geknield in een zone waar achter hem producten lagen opgeslagen.
Assim que o eletroímã chegou perto dele,
Max had ertussen gekneld.
Он даже не успел вскрикнуть.
Его коллеги услышали грохот и попытались помочь. Зазвучала сирена.
Max werd met spoed naar het ziekenhuis overgebracht.
He hadn't switched off the remote control before hanging it on his shoulder.
Ele estava mais interessado em executar a tarefa rapidamente.
Всего одну ошибку.
Thuis wachtte het gezin van Max op zijn thuiskomst van het werk.
In the evening, they would sit and watch TV together.
Max zou zijn oudste zoon met zijn huiswerk helpen, nog even spelen met de kinderen en hen samen met zijn vrouw naar bed brengen.
Em vez disso, hoje receberam uma ligação dizendo que Max não voltaria para casa.
Смерть Макса констатировали спустя час по прибытию в больницу. Сейчас я успокоюсь чуть-чуть.
Ты посмотри.
Сама себя не ожидала.
И... Hoje essa família deve estar sofrendo.
It really puts it into perspective.
you know?
Ja, dat is iets dat iedereen kan overkomen. Ik heb ook twee kindjes. Mijn man werd hier ook. Dus ja, dat is verschrikkelijk.
Je staat er wel meer bij stil natuurlijk. Ik heb ook twee kinderen. Ik kan het mij niet inbeelden dat mijn vrouw er voor gans haar leven alleen zou voorstaan met mijn twee kinderen en dat ik er niet meer zou zijn.
It's heartbreaking to that family. It's devastating as well to the co-workers who work with a person that's been injured or killed.
Para nós como profissional, colegas de trabalho, sentimos o mesmo peso, entendeu? Que a família.
Мне кажется, это идет личное сознание ответственности за себя, за свою жизнь и, наверное, все-таки за свою семью прежде всего.
На мою мнение, os acidentes de trabalho ainda ocorrem, em geral, por descumprimento de algum procedimento, alguma norma de segurança.
Какие-то домашние проблемы, они затмевают разум.
Maar de druk is hoog. En daar gebeuren soms wel een dingen dat je zegt van, ik ga het rap doen.
It could be just that one time we decide to either do something a little different or the same all the time, knowing that I'm taking a shortcut. And that one time can catch you off guard. And that may be your last time.
Eu diria que segurança em primeiro lugar. Então, antes de fazer qualquer coisa, você tem que avaliar o risco, porque a vida a gente só tem uma.
Wat kun je eraan doen? Well, oorzaak voor oorzaak aanpakken.
I actually do speak to most of the new hires that walk through. So what I talk to them and tell them is their eyes and their ears will keep them alive out here.
И стараться, при виде этих нарушений, не бояться, не стесняться подойти к людям, сказать, подсказать.
Safety is not that one time box is ticked and everything will become safe. Safety is a daily job. Safety is every moment's job.
It's the most important part of coming out here. Go home the way we came in.
Porque o bem mais precioso que a gente tem tá na nossa casa, nossos filhos e a nossa família.
Тон на стали, ни одна железяка не стоит человеческой жизни.
So while you're doing your, you know, job and while you're here, think about everything you have outside of here as well and why it matters to be safe.